everything just got really odd. You know, Maggie convinced her father to come to her bridal shower, but in the midst of doing so, you know, he still, you can tell there's still some uncomfortableness that he felt about his daughter being a lesbian. And so, you know, when he saw Maggie kiss Alex after receiving one of their bridal gifts, you know, of course, he stormed out. He said, listen, you know how to endure? I came to this country when I was 9 years old. You know, 11 hours, I was working in a factory. You know, and then he said, he professed even more that, you know, he was the only Mexicana that worked alongside white guys. You know, and he had to endure everything. You know, they would wait outside for him and jump him and beat him up. You know, and years later, he had to earn their respect. And pretty much, they elected, those same people elected him as sheriff. So to see his father, to see his daughter, and he said the one thing they hate more than a Mexicana is a lesbian, is a homosexual. You know, Maggie's saying that things have changed. He said, no, it hasn't. And so now we see, finally, John finally convinced his father that, you know, he's real, that's his actual son. But the reason why he wasn't is because it would bring back memories of his son and family just being so tortured and slaughtered. So it was understandable. Now we're seeing the, I guess we're looking at the moments leading up to the Green Martian extinction, the eradication. You know, we see John's father hanging out with his grandchildren. You know, because he left worship early to surprise John. And then John comes home to surprise his kids. You know, and it's a deep, way deep. This episode is a deep period, man. I didn't expect that, you know, that deepness of, you know, the water be mentioned in this episode. So this is pretty cool. So now, you know, John and his father are hugging me. He said, I'm so sorry for not believing you. He said, why don't you come back here? The staff, father. It's urgent. It's still time. So, oh, bro. Me gone. He says, okay, John. Lights are going to open. Stab is afar. Take him to the hive. So, Martian and Sam are going to go after the staff. Let's see how this goes. Yeah, well, I want to address those. I did not expect to mention the wall in this episode, man. That just goes to show that I love how they can modernize, you know, these kinds of DCW shows, these DC stories, comics, and, you know, still keep it fresh and then original, and then mix in the moderation. I love how they do that. I really do. Gosh, really? Sakara pulls up in a giant's car, blasting Hit Me One More Time by Britney Spears. She really pulls up on White Martians playing Baby Even One More Time by Britney Spears. So there's an onslaught of battling between the Martians and the White Martians and the Green Martians, and I must say they are some heck of fighters, they are. Of course, it's Supergirl. There you go, Pops, there you go. So Kara takes the sash and just starts blasting White Martians away. This is getting supremely dope. There you go. Thank you for my gift. You gave me an amazing gift for a little girl that's not afraid to be who she is anymore. She's pretty much just one of the people who cherish me, who value and cherish me. I don't need you. I don't need you. I'm good. This is dope. Okay, so Maggie tells Alex that, yeah, not having kids has anything not to do with, has nothing to do with her parents or anything like that. The marriage with Alex is enough, and she cherishes that deeply. The only kids I wish were all I need, Alex. Same way. Yeah, this is dope, man. I like this episode. It's pretty darn dope. John and Kara take John's father to Earth. This is great, man. So his dad back to Earth to live a nice life.